These days I'm going home. Day year thing that we should celebrate. song that it's called The Christmas Shoots. It's about what a little boy did to touch a guy's life when he was standing in line waiting to buy a Christmas gift. It was almost Christmas time, and there I stood in another line, trying to buy that last gift or two. I'm really in the Christmas mood. Standing right in front of me was a little boy waiting anxiously, pacing around like little boys do, and in his hands he held pair of shoes, and his clothes were worn and old. He was dirty from head to toe, and when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. So I wanna buy new shoes for my mama, please. Christmas time, and we think these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes would make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. Just give it that out. Tell me, sir, what I'm gonna do.
Next Saturday night.
Next Saturday night, the 5th.
At 7 o'clock at Bethesda.
All right. Well, thank you for stopping by.
Thank you for allowing me to.
When I was but a youngster, Christmas meant one thing, that I'd be getting lots of toys that day. I learned a whole lot different when Mother sat me down and taught me to spell Christmas this way.
Santa Claus is coming to town. Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus.
just a wee little boy, full of health and joy. One Christmas morning I see marvelous little toy. A wonder to behold it was, many colors bright. And the moment I laid eyes on it, it became my heart's delight. It went zipping, it blew, bopped and stopped, when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. The first time that I picked it up, I had a big surprise. For right on the bottom were two big butts, looked like big green eyes. I first pushed one, then the other, then I twisted and split. And when I sat it down again, this is what it did. It went zip when it moved, bop when it stopped, furrow when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. It first marched left, then marched right, then marched under a chair. And when I looked where it had been, it wasn't even there. I started to cry, my daddy laughed, he knew that I would find. When I looked around, my marvelous toy was chugging from behind. It went zip when it blew, bop when it stopped, when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. Well, the years have passed too quickly, it seems, and my own little boy. And yesterday, I gave to him a marvelous little toy. His eyes nearly popped right out of his head. He gave his will of glee. Neither one of us knows just what it is, but he loves it just like me. It still goes zip when it moves, bop when it stops, when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never.
Traveling, Lord. caught up into the, not really the Christmas season, but the Christmas hubbub, trying to see how much money we can spend and concentrating on gifts and getting and how much more we can do than last year. That's not what it's all about. And we as Christians know that, but we still get caught up in that. So let's concentrate as much as we possibly can. Let's change our hearts about presents. And what am I going to get this year? And what am I going to give this year? I have to spend $100 more this year than I did last year, because so-and-so is going to spend $100 more. Let's change that mindset if we can. And we can, because we're Christians and we know where our beginnings and our ends are. So if you can do that, I'm going to try to do it. Anyway, things are so expensive, I can't afford them anyway. But I'm going to ask my son-in-law's daddy's mother, or whatever it is over here, to close us in prayer. But I want to thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. Our group is not nearly as big, but we've got the creme de la creme right here. We got the cream of the crop.
And we are going to do this New Year's Eve. Everybody on stage said they could be here, so y'all on the team, we're all going to make it till midnight, I promise you that. But if you want to join us for New Year's Eve,
bring your little hats and your little whatever to see. Go to the car with them, because we're not.
And Margaret's message meant a lot to me. It means that I'm just not going to get you a gift this year.
I take it all back.
That's a good message.
Just to add to what Margaret had to say about presents, let us remember one thing. We have received the greatest present that any person or being could ever give us, and that is the salvation of our souls through the Lord Jesus Christ. That was the most precious gift that anybody could ever give. His only begotten Son, that He shed His blood and died on Calvary and rose the third day, that we might be able to have the freedom, the liberty, the abundant life, share the abundant life that He gave us through His shed blood. Let's dwell on that this season, please. And the gift that keeps on giving, that He keeps on giving, is the gift of His love, and love is the key. Love never fails. And love for one another is the most precious thing that you'll ever have in your life. And that is one for another. And service to one to another. That is the Christ way. Blessed Heavenly God, our Father, thank You for Your love and Your mercy and Your grace this day, Father. And in this season that You have given to us, Lord, let us be mindful as to those who may not be as fortunate as Christians, Lord, that might be hurting, may have lost loved ones, that may not be able to share in the happiness and the joy that You have given us through Your sweet Spirit, through Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank You for the salvation and plan that You've given unto us, Lord. And right now, Lord, we ask for a special anointing of Your sweet, precious Holy Spirit upon this season, that to keep us ever so mindful of that which the reason for the season. It's not about commercialism. It's been proselytized and prostituted, Lord, and taken away from its true meaning. And, Lord, we need to represent You in the more mighty and powerful way, Lord. But others may want to see, they can see You in us, Lord. Because for us, in our walk, Lord, some people, we are the only Bible that some people will ever see. Father, bless these people, Lord. This is a precious congregation. And I thank You so much for it, Lord. Bless them, keep them, and ever so mindful, Lord, just give them a double dose of Your sweet, precious Spirit this season, Lord. And we will be sure to give You all the glory, all the praise, all of the honor with our Lord, in Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Ricky. We all have a safe trip home, and hope to see you into December. For those who can, we've got to get these chairs stacked up, eight in a stack.